Welcome back and welcome to the third module where we're really going to dive into security. And the way we're going to approach this module is by looking at security capabilities and tasks. So at a high level, if we look at some of the capabilities that are available in Azure SQL, you're going to see a lot of overlap with capabilities you're familiar with in SQL Server on premises. In addition to that, after each capability, we're going to try to wrap it up and tell you how we recommend you set up and configure these things as tasks, whether it's your network security, your data protection, auth, or monitoring.
You know, think about Azure SQL. It has to be enterprise class security, just like SQL Server. So as Anna just mentioned, we need to have capabilities and give you the ability to do tasks that meet your security needs. And so in this module, you're going to see kind of four major areas that we're going to give and show you the capabilities, tasks along with them, along with some demos. This includes network security for things like private link or maybe identity and access to show you how to do Active Directory authentication into your Azure SQL database. Or it can be data protection, show you the different encryption options and even things like dynamic data masking. And then finally, you need to manage this whole thing. So we're going to show you various aspects of Azure SQL security management, things like you're familiar with, like auditing, but also new capabilities, like things like advanced threat protection. Okay, so you've seen how we're going to talk about security. We're going to talk about these capabilities in these various areas, like network security, authentication, encryption and protection, and management, and then show you tasks and demos that make up those different areas. Look forward to seeing you in the next video.